I'm going to start sharing my screen of Toastmasters International website. So you all are aware this is the Toastmasters International website, and we do everything through this portal. First, when you join any Toastmasters club, you will be getting the access to this website. First thing you have to do this login, where you will be entering your email ID. If you are a new member, you will not get any password. But what you have to do is that you have to enter your I already logged in, that is why I'm not able to do this now. I already logged in, so you have to log in by giving your email ID. Then the one time password you will get through your email. Then you can change your password in your profile. So once you have this access, username and password, then you can log in to the Toastmasters International website. Here we have so many sub sessions here. You can see all these. But where we have to do this projects through the pathways, this is the area we have to go through the pathways. When you are a new member, first we have to choose a path. Path means in Toastmaster pathways, there are 11 paths. It covers nearly 300 competencies. 11 paths, 300 competencies. So you have to choose one of the path in the beginning. And each path will cover 5 levels with 14 projects. So first you have to choose a path. Out of 11 paths, you have to choose one. This way you choose a path. The language is select English. Then there are two options to get your study materials. This is obtain digital resources or acquire printed material in the mail. So it is the printed material is not available for all 11 paths, only a few three or four paths only they have the printed materials, but still you have to pay $25 for each path. So usually we go through this digital resources. So we select digital resources. Then we have to select one of the 11 paths. Again, we have two ways to select the paths. Either you can select directly or you take an assessment. So first we will take an assessment. Okay, how we will see how this assessment is going to take. So take an assessment to choose your first path. So we are starting the selection of our path. So there will be so many questions they will be asking. Select three topics you are interested in learning about from the list below. So when you select, it will go to the next tab. It will ask, so again, the next question. when you answer all these questions, it will give you, it will recommend one path for you to follow your education decision. Education learning in pathways. Again, it is your choice. You choose that particular recommended path, or you can select some other path. It is your choice. But based on this question and answer, the system will recommend the suitable path for you. So always we recommend to go for this recommended path when you are selecting your first path. So when I replied all these questions, the website recommended me one of the path which is called leadership development. Here again, you can find learn more about the lead. So you can get more details about this project in this recommended area. And if you want to go know more detail about these projects in this path, here when you click, it will give you all the level five levels in this path. See, this is level one where you have to do the ice breaking, evaluation, feedback, research, presenting. Then level two, learning your style, increase knowledge. So this is the five levels in this leadership and development path. So you can select this path, or you can go back to your That was the best way to select your first path. And the second way to select your path is, if you are already aware of all the 11 paths, so then you can select any of these paths by your own option. See, here it is. There are 11 paths. It is showing all the 11 paths. So you can go through the details of each path and you can select any of these paths. I hope it is clear for you all that how to select a path. Any questions here? I'm asking the audience, any questions here? So you know how to select a path. There is no questions. Okay. This is for the selection of the first path. When you are selecting the second path, the same way, but you have to pay $20 for the second path. Only the first path, it is given for free of charge. But actually, it is not free of charge. When you join a new club as a new member, you are paying $20 as a membership fee, new member fee. So actually, that $20 is taken for this path, the first path. The first path is free. The second thing is that if you are a dual member, if you are a member of two clubs, you can get your second path for free. What you have to do is that you select any of the path and send an email to supply orders at toastmasters.org. You just send an email that I have selected so-and-so path as my second path. and I am a dual member. So after 3 days or 4 days, it will be appearing in your base camp as your second part. So you don't have to pay the extra $20 for your second path if you are a dual member. That means you are a member of two clubs or more clubs. Okay, once you have selected your path, what the next step is that we start doing our projects. So here again, we go back to the pathways. Here in this way, you go to base camp. Base camp, actually base camp means it is the gateway to pathways. Anything and everything is available in this base camp for the pathways education. So we will go to the base camp. We are already logged in. So now we are going to the base camp. I am a member of two clubs. So if you are a member of two clubs, you have to select which club you are representing now. Go to base camp. Base camp, we are going to the path and learning the education transcript. Okay, firstly, we will go there. These are the two paths I am following right here. Okay, so when you join in the pathways, you already select one of the paths. So, for example, you say you selected the path presentation mastery. Then we will be opening the curriculum. Here you will find all the projects in 5 levels. Here you saw there are two paths because I selected two paths. So for you, you may see only one path there. The first, the presentation mastery, there are 5 levels. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In the first level, the first speech of any Toastmaster is the pathway, the ice breaking. The first speech is ice breaking. That is the first project. First, we have to activate that project. When you activate it, it will be showing the status as registered. Okay. Before activation, it will be showing not activated. When you activated, it will be showing registered or activated. Then next, again, you will be going to the launch. When you launch, you will be getting all the details of the project. We are going to launch the project. Okay, the first project, icebreaker, level 1 project. So we are going to start. We are going to begin the assessment. So in this one, we will see all the details of this particular project. We begin. It will give you more details about this particular project. And it will explain how to navigate this pathways to projects. This is an introduction. Icebreaking speech means it's an introduction speech. You may have participated in icebreaking activity at an event in your life. So it will give more details. this one is very important. So before you give your speech or the project in your club, you have to assess your skills, your current skill about this one. So this is before, assess your skills before giving the project. Here the question here is asked, I am confident and calm when speaking in front of the groups. I understand the structure of a basic speech. I am aware of my strength as a communicator and leader. I am aware of where I need to improve my communication, listening, thinking, and speaking and leadership skills. This is your assessment before you give your project. Once you complete your project, again, you have to go back. And so you are submitting your assessment before giving the project. So it is done. So what is the next step? Is to do the project. Again, you are moving to the next tab. There you will find more details about this particular project. So now we just did the assessment of your skills before doing the project. Now you will get the explanations or competencies you are going to meet in this particular project. So these are the competencies. The following is a list of competencies that you will learn and practice in this project. So based on this, we will be preparing our speech. There will be videos to support your project. So based on that, you can prepare your presentation or your speech. These are the details of this particular project. Now, once you did your project, you already presented your ice-breaking speech in your club. So again, we have to come back to this assessment. We have to launch the program and we will be reaching to this tab. And here we will be giving our assessment after the speech. So we already did the speech. Now we have a different experience than the previous experience before doing, and now we are going to do the assessment after our speech. There is another tip I want to share with you that, see, here in the resources, you will be getting the evaluation resource, Print My Project, Icebreaker Speech Outline Worksheet. Here, in this evaluation resource, you will be getting only these two pages of that evaluation sheet. But that may not be enough for an evaluator to evaluate your particular projects. What I always suggest is that Print My Project. When you print your project, all the details which you saw right now on the screen, all the details will be coming in a PDF form. And if you share this complete project details to your evaluator, you will be getting a better feedback from this evaluator. So once you complete the ice-breaking speech, now what is next is that now, this is the assessment of your skills after your presentation. Now, I am assessing all after my speech. certainly there will be some improvements in our skills. So the feedback, see, this is our my feedback. Before it was 3-3-3. Now after the presentation of my speech, it is improved actually. Now we have completed my first project in the pathways in the website. The physically also we did the speech in the club, and in pathways also we completed the first part. Now you see this in the screen, the status of the project is completed. Similarly, we will be completing all these projects in level one, the evaluation and feedback and research and presentation. And after completion of all this project, we will be submitting level one completion. So when all this completed, it will be showing that submit for your level one completion. This is how one level is completed. Then we will be moving to the next level, that is level two. There are different projects like this. Then we activate, we launch, and then we do the assessment before the speech, and we do the speech. Then after the speech, again, we do the assessment after the project. Then we complete that project. Then it will be showing like it is completed. So again, you complete all these projects, then level two, you submit the level two completion, then the level two will be completed. When you submit this level two or level one completion, a message will go to the BP Education and the president or the secretary of the club. They are the base camp managers. They will approve your level completion. Once they complete, they approve, then only it will be shown as the level completed. When we complete all these five levels, the last one is the path completion. Like we did here, after all these three projects, we said the level completed. Then here, when we complete all five levels, we say path completion. This is basically we do the activate and launching our education program, and based on that project details we do the projects. This is how I do my projects in pathways. If you have any questions, anything you want more to know, please let me know.
Can I ask one question, Didiam, to Soma?
Yes, sir.
We can do both paths in the same time, or we have to finish one, then go to second?
We can do one or two or more than one path anytime.
In the same club? Or?
No, you can. It is not the club, it is you. Okay, as a member, Toastmaster member, you can do the selection of path, one, two, or three. For example, myself, I selected three paths at a time. Okay, and it is up to us when we complete one level. Okay, when we are completing, we are submitting the level completion. That time we have to be careful. Okay, so that time we have to be very particular that I select Riyadh Malayalam Toastmasters Club. Then you submit level completion. Then the message will go to the Basecamp manager of Riyadh Malayalam Toastmasters. So if you are selecting Elite 30 Advanced Toastmasters Club, this message will go to the Basecamp managers of Riyadh Elite 30 Toastmasters Club. So in that particular session only, you have to be more careful. Otherwise, it doesn't matter. At the same time, you can do different paths. 1, 2, 3 paths you can do. And one cup, either you can do like that. No, in one one club, you select and do one path. In another club, you can select and do the second path. You can do mix also. For example, in the level one, there is a project. You give your speech and get feedback. And after getting feedback, you repeat the speech, right? So in this one, usually I do the first speech in one club. I get the feedback and I go to the next club to repeat the speech rather than doing the same speech in the same club. So I do this in different clubs. So this way also you can do that.
Just one more thing, DTM Krishna Omar. Now I think we had the option of selecting the second path for free. I think there was a communication from TMI. So is it still open that we can select the second path free?
I'm not sure because it was an offer given when the pandemic started. It was last year, 2020. That time only I selected my third path for free. Okay.
March 31st, it's expired. Now there is no more free path.
No, free. Maybe there will be some another announcement. We can wait, right?
Yes, definitely.
Maybe from the area itself. Okay. Now there is no free path. There is no free path now. But if you are a dual member, as I said, if you are a dual member, you can get the second path for free.
Okay, thank you.
For that, what you have to do is that you select your path and you email to You just send an email to this that I have selected so-and-so path and I am a member of a dual club. So automatically after 3 days or 4 days, it will be appearing in your profile as your second path. If you already selected two paths, it will be your third path.
Well, I have a question.
So in addition to Toastmaster Murali Krishna's query, okay, if I am a member of only one club, okay, I have selected two paths, okay, but I am planning to go with one by one. First, I will complete first path and I will go to second path. That is not sure. But in the same path, I can mix up with two level. It means I didn't complete first path. Can I deliver my speech from second path? Is it allowed, sir?
It is open. It is open. You can do that one. Okay. Yeah. Before completing level one, you can start giving the projects in level two. But for personally, I don't recommend this, at least for the level one and level two. Because level one and exactly. Level two are the basics. Okay. Level one and level two are the basics. So we do according, better to go according to the sequence. Example, the first speech in level one is ice breaking. So it is an introduction speech. So before doing that one, if you are doing the another speech, so it is, it will not help you to develop yourself. So at least you complete level one and level two, then you can go for the other options. For another example, I will give you. In level 4 or level 5, there is a project of HPL, High Performance Leadership. This opportunity you may not get any time. So now you are doing your level 2. So now you are getting an opportunity to do the HPL. So you do that project right now. and you record it as a level the project completion.
Yeah.
When the time comes after you complete level 2, level 3, then level 4, so it will be the project already did, and it will be there as a project completed. So you can do this way. Otherwise, I don't recommend that you jump into another level before you complete the previous level. But still,
you can
do that one.
Thank you, sir. And one more clarification. If I completed level 2 or level 3, okay, I got one opportunity to do my HPL, and I complete all the projects in level 5. So I want to submit level 5 before submitting level 4. Did I get a credit to our club for level 5? After that, can I get level 4 credit to my club?
See, no, actually in Pathways, as a member, when you are completing level completion, suppose I am submitting in Pathways, okay? Remember Pathways, I am submitting that I completed my level 3, okay? It is only your completion. The club will not get that point.
Okay.
Okay. For the club to get the point, the DCP point, what they have to do is that they have to go to the base camp, the BP education or any EXCO member, they have to go to the base camp, not the base camp, actually.
Club Central.
Club, yeah. Club Central, and they submit the education awards.
Yeah.
In that area, if you did not complete your level 2 and they cannot submit for level 3, there it will come in the sequence only. When understood, right?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. Okay. In the club central, the BP education cannot submit your level 3 completion or level 4 completion till you complete the previous levels in that one. For example, so I don't have the access to the club central, but if you go there, it will be showing, okay, if I select, if I am going to the club central, and I select Toastmaster Kabir, it will be showing their completion of level 2 only. But maybe you want to submit level 3, it will not be showing there. It will be showing the last one, that is level 2. So when they submit the level 2, immediately they can submit the level 3 also.
Okay, sir. Okay, thank you. Just for your information, actually, in Club Central, it's appearing all the levels. Actually, we can submit our level 5 even if we did not complete level 4. It's possible to submit level 5. In that case, okay, club cannot get credit for his level 4. If he submit his level 5, then club should not get will not get level 4. Okay, this is what I have experienced in previous year. That is why I write this question. This may help for VP education. When they are going to submit any member's education award, it may helpful for them. Let them check in the club central also. If it is only appearing the next level, if a member completed their level 2, then it's appearing only level 3, it's okay. If it's appearing level 4, level 5, then VP education should take care of it. They should not submit, skip any level, then they should not get the credit to their club. So they have to take care of this point.
Toastmaster Kabir, okay, actually, I have a different experience. Maybe this is a new development in the club central. So let me clarify once again that, okay, if I did not complete my level 2, but completed my level 3.
Yeah.
Okay, so the BP education can submit level 3 for my education awards. That is what you meant.
Yes, sir, definitely. Yes, sir, definitely. There is an option. BP education will get the information of your level 3 completion. If they are he approved and he updated in the club central also, then you will get credit for level 3. Club also will get credit for level 3. But after you complete your level 2, you will get your level 2 also, level 2 certificate. But for the club, they cannot get their credit for level 2. you will get only the higher education.
Okay, understood. Okay, okay. So maybe this is a new development in the
maybe, maybe, yeah.
Any other questions? Okay, one of the, another one I want to mention here that okay, when we complete okay, DTM. So that is what we ultimately look forward. DTM means that it's like a diploma or a degree in Toastmasters. How to attain the DTM? How to become a DTM in Pathways? What we have to do become a DTM in Pathways is that. We have to complete two paths, okay? Then we have to serve as a club officer for 12 months. It can be either two officer post in 6 months and 6 months. So we have to serve the club as a officer for 12 months. The third one is serve as a club mentor or a club coach. Club mentor or a club coach. And one more thing is that serve as a district officer for 1 year. You have to serve the district like an area director or division director or a district director. Any district officer for 1 year. And serve as a club sponsor. You have to sponsor a club or conduct a speech craft or youth leadership. Finally, you have to do one DTM project. So this is how we can become a distinguished Toastmaster through the pathways. We have to complete two paths, serve as a club officer for 12 months, serve as a club mentor or coach, serve as a district officer for 1 year, serve as a club sponsor or conduct a speech craft or youth leadership. Then finally, complete the DTM project. And DTM project, now you may not have access to this DTM project. You will be having this access once you complete one path and three levels in the second path. Understood. Then you have to send one email message to education program about your DTM project. Then they will activate your DTM project in your profile or in the Basecamp portal. Till that moment, you will not see about the DTM project in your profile. This is about the DTM.
I think Toastmaster Prem Kumar has a question.
Yes, Toastmaster.
Well, time is up. Anyway, my questions, actually not one question, two questions are there. First one, see, I have completed my first level and I am starting my second level. Again, the level, second path. So the level one is quite common for all the paths, I believe.
Yes, so I have level one and level two are basically same.
So I have to repeat the level one and level two for the second path too, correct?
Yes, of course, yes.
Well, now the question is, when we are filling the assessment skills, see, before speaking, like the ice-breaking part in my path one, I accomplished with the 5, means excellent. And when we are going for the level one, again, I will fill with 5, correct?
Yeah, it will be before and after, it will be 5. It will be excellent. We don't have more than excellent. Excellent is the maximum.
Yeah, so there is no room for another excellence.
You can develop yourself. So when you are doing, see, this question I always listen. I did my ice breaking before. Why I have to do my ice breaking again? This is the common question all the people ask. But my answer to this is that you gave an ice breaking speech, but you can give the same speech, your introduction in a different way, right? There were untold stories of yourself. You can do introduce yourself in different way. For example, what I did, maybe you are aware of that. I did my ice breaking always already in Kohinoor, once in Elite 30. And when I did my my second path, I did my ice breaking in Riyadh Malayalam Club. That is in Malayalam. So this is a different way of approaching the projects. You can do the projects in a different way. So rather than telling that, why should I do this same thing? It's not just for doing the projects. You will get different experiences. Now I am planning to do my next ice breaking in Riyadh Tamil Toastmasters Club in Tamil.
Always welcome, sir.
Yeah. See, this is how we do. This is how we do the different experience. There also, Toastmaster Prem Kumar, how you speak in Tamil. So when you do the assessment before, it will be 3 or 4 only.
உங்களுக்கு தமிழ் அறியுமா?
கொஞ்சம் கொஞ்சம். So I think it answers your question, Toastmaster Prem.
Well, yes.
So, thank you very much once again for the opportunity. I hope I justified. If you have any more questions, still I am learning. For doing this presentation, I go through the projects once again, and I got new information.
One question more.
Yes, sir.
So you said to become a TTM.
Yes.
There are few conditions you said. This any of this condition has to be met, or all the condition to be met.
All the conditions.
Okay. It should be a officer. One should be a mentor. Then one should be a coach.
Yes.
Right. Then yes, you do the project.
Yeah. Toastmaster Binu, actually, this is also a part of the development. When you are doing these two paths, when you are completing, you are developing your communication and leadership within the club. And when you are becoming a club officer, you are moving to the next level. And the next level is serving as a district officer. This is the next level. So when you become a distinguished Toastmaster, it means you completed all the levels, and you will see a huge difference between when you did your icebreaking speech and when you become a distinguished Toastmaster. So we go through all this experience, and this experience will help you in your personal and your professional career. This is the purpose of this project.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much once again. Back to the Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you, DTM Krishnakumar. തീർച്ചയായിട്ടും വളരെ വിശദമായി തന്നെ ഒരു പുതിയ അംഗം എങ്ങനെയാണ് ഒരു പാത്ത് വേസ് തുടങ്ങുന്നത് എന്ന് അദ്ദേഹം ഇവിടെ നമുക്ക് വ്യക്തമായിട്ട് കാണിച്ചു തന്നു. താങ്ക് യു വെരി മച്ച് ഫോർ അക്സെപ്റ്റിംഗ് അവർ ഇൻവിറ്റേഷൻ ആൻഡ് കണ്ടക്ടിങ് ദ ക്ലാസ്. Thank you very much. ഇനി നമുക്ക് ഇന്നത്തെ സെഷൻ നമ്മുടെ ഒന്ന് നീണ്ടുപോയി. കാരണം ഈ ഒരു പഠനം നമുക്ക് ഒരിക്കലും അവസാനിക്കുന്നില്ല, എന്നും നമ്മൾ പഠിച്ചുകൊണ്ടേയിരിക്കുകയാണ്. പ്രത്യേകിച്ചും ടോസ്റ്റ് മാസ്റ്റർ അത് തന്നെയാണ് നമ്മളോട് പറയുന്നത്, ഇതൊരു പഠന കളരിയാണ്. അപ്പൊ നമുക്ക് നമ്മുടെ അജണ്ട അനുസരിച്ച് ഒരു ചെറിയ ഇടവേള വെച്ചിരുന്നു. എല്ലാ അതിഥികളെ ഒന്ന് കൂടുതൽ അറിയാനായിട്ട്, അപ്പൊ നമുക്ക് ഒരു 2 മിനിറ്റ് ഒന്ന് റിലാക്സ് ചെയ്തതിന് ശേഷം, അല്ലെ, കുറെ പഠിച്ച് എല്ലാവരും ഒന്നിങ്ങനെ തളർന്നിരിക്കുകയാണെന്ന് തോന്നുന്നുണ്ട്. അപ്പൊ ഒന്ന് നമുക്കൊന്ന് ഇന്ന് റിലാക്സ് ചെയ്തതിന് ശേഷം തിരിച്ച് നമുക്ക് നമ്മുടെ മീറ്റിംഗിലേക്ക് വരാം.
തന്റെ പുസ്തകത്തിൽ